So today what we're going to do, we're going to do some coding in the car with Bimmercode. I recently took the car to the dealership and they had to work on the car, and as a result, all my customizations were wiped off. So I have to re-add all the customizations that I like. Things like making your mirrors fold when you lock the doors, having the car start in sport mode. So there are quite a few little customizations that I like to have on the car that were completely wiped out that I had before. So I'm going to take you through the process of setting that up and getting that working in your car. Things you'll need to make this work is you'll need Bimmercode, of course, the app. It's about $30 in the App Store. And you'll need a OBD-II Bluetooth connector. I'm using the one from Veepeak. It's also somewhere in the range of $25-$30. I'll leave a link to it in the notes. And so the first thing you do is you take this and you plug it in your OBD port. For me, it's right around where my left foot rests, underneath the steering wheel. So we're gonna plug that in, and then we'll fire up Bimmercode, and we'll get this working. You will need to power on the car to do this work. So, but you don't want to turn on the ignition. Just turn on the power. And then we're going to open up Bimmercode and start working on this. So I'm opening up Bimmercode. It's connecting. So I'm going to go ahead and hit continue. And this does take a little while for the Bimmercode to read all the vehicle ECUs, all the vehicle computers. So that does take a little bit. So just be patient there. I'm going to sort of speed this up in the video. Once it reads everything, then you can go in and actually code different portions of the car. So I'll show you how to do that in just a second. One of the things that I like to have off with my car is I like to turn the active sound design off. Basically, that's a feature where in a lot of minis, they will pump sound into the car, artificial sound. So it sounds you get fictitious engine noise. So I usually deactivate that. So I'm going to deactivate that and code it. And that will turn that feature off. So I'm not getting the artificial engine noise coming into the car. So that actually is a module that's quick to code. Only takes a couple seconds to turn that off. Now for the sport mode, one of the things I like is to have the car start in sport mode. And because I'm always driving in sport mode. So we're going to go in the body domain controller and shift that so that the car starts in sport mode. And then we're going to change the mirror so the mirrors close. There's some other little tweaks that we'll add as well, but those were the three things that I wanted to do on this video. So we're setting the mirrors to fold automatically. We want unfold mirrors with convenient opening, fold mirrors with convenient closing. The other thing that we changed was I changed my indicator light flashing when we're locking the car to 3 times instead of 1. I like to have a better clear indication that the car is locked. The folding mirrors also helps. And we changed the default driving mode to sport. And You can change all kinds of stuff, like the temperature of your seat heating. You can dial that in just right to your preference. So we're changing quite a few little things along since we're in here. We've got most of the things that we wanted to change. So I'm going to go ahead and code this BDC. And that's going to take just a minute to code. So that coded successfully. There's some things in the head unit that I'd also like to get coded. One of the things that really annoys me with these cars is when you start the car, you get that prompt in the head unit display. You can turn that off with Bimmercode. So we're going to go ahead and turn that message off and make it so that that doesn't show up and you start the car and it just goes straight into whatever the last setting was. So I'm going to go ahead and code that in. So that setting is called warning at startup. So we're going to make that not active. One of the other things I'm going to add is I'm going to change the tire pressure control. And that will add the temperature as well as the pressure of the tires when you look at the tire pressures. So that's a nice feature to have if you're doing some fast driving or on a track. You'll be able to monitor the temperature of each tire. I've found that pretty useful in the past on track days. And that's it. I think that'll get me back to wherever, you know, the settings that I had set up before. So we're going to go ahead and code that, start coding. And that also should just take a second, and then it'll restart the head unit, and we'll be all done there. When you're done with Bimmercode, make sure you disconnect from it. That's probably a good idea to tell your car, hey, we're no longer going to be doing this. So make sure you disconnect. Don't just plug out your OBD connector. Don't just shut down the app. Go ahead and disconnect. It's probably a better way to do it. So we're all done. We've got everything coded that we needed to get. Quick and simple. Took us just a few minutes to get everything coded. Now we're going to go ahead and start the car up and see some of these changes. And I'll show you what it looks like when I lock the car and unlock the car so that you'll see what happens with the lights and with the mirrors. As you can see, the mirrors unfold when you unlock the door, and they fold when you lock the door, and the indicator lights flash three times when you lock, and that's one of the things I changed. Just a good visual indicator. Let's start the car. Now the car should start in sport mode. So if we take a look, you can see that it is in sport mode right from the start. So now I don't have to go ahead and change that every time I drive the car. Thank you for joining us. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. While you're down there, go ahead and subscribe. That helps us a lot.